This is the MacBook Pro 2020 and this is the review of this amazing laptop. This review is not going to be like other reviews. I am going to tell everything about the product, but towards the end, I am going to share my comparison with the new M1 MacBooks. They have been released a few days ago, and since both the devices are pretty much the same, not any major changes except the processor, so I think it's fair enough to draw a comparison between two. And if you like these review videos, let me know in the comments below. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already, and without further ado, let's get into the video. So back to what I was saying. So this is the 13-inch base model, which means this is running at Intel's Core i5 with 8GB of RAM on board. So performance-wise, being a base model, it delivers great speed and great performance. Not that groundbreaking, I agree, but is decent enough to run any task on it. And being a 13-inch version, it's very lightweight and compact and easy to carry. The screen is an excellent Retina display, which delivers great colors with very minimum bezels on the side. What I love the most about these MacBooks is the mousepad. I just am in love with these mousepads. This is a very generous size with excellent drivers, gestures and everything are on point, and you don't get to see them on any other laptop. Now let's talk about the new keyboards and which have been the most impressive part of this year. This is what justifies why you should buy these instead of the previous versions. The main point is the typing comfort. Previously, the MacBook had an issue with this. Their butterfly switches were not the best keyboard. That was the most controversial and problematic hardware design in Apple's history. Many users also faced the issue that keys stopped working in between. But with the introduction of this new Magic Keyboard, the issue is resolved. There is a good amount of key travel, the typing experience is much, much more better. I use it for a good amount of time and I enjoyed the typing experience on it. And I honestly appreciate when there is key travel in the keyboard. That's why I'm a big fan of mechanical keyboards. This keyboard is backlit, so it's also a plus on that part. But this feels like Apple is listening to its user complaint and is providing them value with the new products. Moving on to the ports, the base model only comes with two Thunderbolt 3 ports on the left side and a headphone jack on the right side. But if you were to upgrade to the high-end version, you will be getting four Thunderbolt 3, two on each side. If you have two ports, one is already being used for charging and you are left with only one, and since there's only Type-C on board, we'll be needing some sort of dongle to get additional ports, and I'll also link some in the description below so you can check it out there as well. This version of MacBook has a separate and dedicated escape key and also a fingerprint sensor, because a lot of time when you get stuck in programs, you need escape key to get out of it. Battery life is decent, is good enough, it will deliver 10 plus hours. And the webcam 720p is also good enough. So with this review out of the way, we know what a MacBook looks like and how it is, what components it has. The main difference today, what we have are the two options available with Intel processor and M1 chip processor. And this is where I believe the complications start taking place. Because you see, the new chips are powerful, no doubt, very powerful in some cases. It also gives out great battery life. MKBHD in his review told that he got 4 days of battery life from his MacBook. Like, that's insane. That's amazing. Like, why wouldn't a person want that much battery power in his device? Which means the numbers that Apple were showing on the launch are quite promising. But the main thing that is troubling me is that every component is joined together, right? The RAM is also baked in. On one side, it has great benefits that if you combine and bring all the components closer together, this means that they will communicate and talk to each other more efficiently and the task will be done more rapidly. But at the same time, look at it from this perspective that these chips are most powerful right now, but there are more future years to come ahead. And in those years, this might not feel that powerful anymore. You will be stuck with whatever thing you have, right? If you buy the 8GB RAM version now, you are stuck with it for the rest of the computer's life. You cannot upgrade the RAM because it's entirely impossible now. At first, in previous years as well, it was quite difficult to replace the RAM or anything in MacBooks, but now it's impossible to do it. So now what is happening is Apple has control over everything. You eventually have to get the version with more RAM, even though your use does not require you that much amount of power, but you will be getting it so that you future-proof it for next 10, 15 years, right? It's just like buying a new phone. Today, if you buy the latest and the greatest phone, the best in the game, that will deliver great power compared to previous years, but next year or maybe a few years later, newer chipset will come out with more RAM, with more power, you'll be forced to buy the one that is the most high-end. The same, this will happen with MacBooks. You will be getting the highest end in order to future-proof it, but then again, there's going to be something more powerful coming. This is what has been troubling me the most, and at the end, this is my opinion. This is what I feel, and I would not be interested in a product which limits me in any way. I would like to keep my options open. I will give this M1 technology a couple more years until it grows and I see where this technology is leading, and then can decide if I have to go in that bandwagon or not. Or I might end up waiting a couple more years to see what it turns out like. So that's been it. This was my review for the new MacBooks. Thanks for watching. Hope you guys liked it. Make sure to drop a like to the video and comment if you have any views of your own, and share with your friends, help each other out, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And I'll catch you guys in the next one. Bye bye.